nature. Call you God. Worthy it's your name. We worship your majesty. Limande bronta hila kabasheketo branamas. A great God. You are God. Mighty. I am miracle. We're standing on your holy name. Oh Lord, we bow. Mande bonta hila kabashekendo lo bonta hila brahadesh. Oh, my enemonta brasheketo piana. Father, we worship you, Jesus. Lift up your hands and worship this God. We recognize your supremacy, O God. Your sovereignty, makande bronta la brahadesh. Oh, we worship your majesty. Holy. Ale bronta hila pa shekenda la brahande zorodosh. Call you God. It's your name. Mene manto brahade segede brahande shata. We join the 24 elders in heaven to bow before your royal majesty, Jesus. Awesome God, oh, a great hour. My enemies are my sheketosh. Oh, you are God, mighty. I am a miracle. We stand in awe, oh, on a holy ground. Oh Lord, we bow and worship you. King of kings, Lord of love, Lord of sin, all soon come a king. King of kings, Lord of love, everlasting king, Savior, Redeemer, soon come a king. My name is Shakanda Rebonta Hilabayana Mashaketenda. Mene monta, Father, you are the soon coming King. We worship you. Mayene moshi kandele bronta hila gabayene mosondosh. Ikalia mande bronta hila mayene monda la brashata. Ele monta hi Jesus. Oh, soon coming King. Mane moshendele bronta hila gabayene monta la brash. Savior Redeemer, soon coming King. We worship you, Jesus. Oh Lord, we are in your presence again today, Father. We ask for the glory to fill this house, oh Father. Let the atmosphere be charged with your presence, oh. Oh, Savior, Redeemer, so come, King. Eli Roshandela Bonta Brahadesayanamash. Oh Lord, we worship you. We recognize your supremacy, Jesus. Holy God, righteous God. Nemonta Branamashekede. Oh, awesome God. Nemonta Branamashekendo Branamash. Oh Lord. Oh, you are awesome in this place. Father, we give you tithes. Lord, I worship you. Thank you, awesome God. Thank you, Jesus. Beautiful people of God, I'd like to ask you a question. Do you really know how big, how great, how awesome is this God? I'd like you to answer this question within yourself. The Bible says in Psalm 147 verse 5, it says, great is our God. Do you know how awesome this God is? Another word for awesome is incredible. Another word for awesome is magnificent. Another word for awesome is unbelievable. Another word for awesome is greatness. Mashakata Brahandish. It then means that the God that you and I are serving is an incredible God that does awesome things, that does incredible things. Makabashekenda ilakata Brahandish. Why did I take my time to give you the different definition of the word awesome? Mande bronta hilaga bashata. I am not trying to entertain you. I am not an entertainer. I am a kingdom ambassador, a woman of God. But I gave you this different definition for you to know how awesome God is, for you to have an in-depth knowledge of how great the God you are praying to is, how big this God is. For you to have an in-depth knowledge of his ability and capacity. That's why I gave you the different definition of that word awesome. Because this understanding of the God and ability and capacity of God will destroy and kill anxiety, fear, and worries. Mashakande brunta haladosh. The Bible says in Isaiah chapter 41 verse 10, it says, fear not, for I'm with thee. The knowledge of the size of God will destroy fear. I will never forget one time in my life. Likrana masontolo brunta hadashata. Enemonta hilia mandebosh. I will never forget this time. One time I went for a checkup. In Europe, in the Western world, we're very big on health. The government will even advise you to go for your regular medical checkup, which is good. I went for my checkup, and the doctor said to me, he saw, so many years ago, he said he saw a growth. As a matter of fact, he saw ovarian cysts. You all know what it is. And I was laughing. I was smiling. The doctor was surprised. He said, why are you smiling? This is a very delicate, problem. And you need to go for a surgery and all of that. And you're smiling. I was smiling because I know the God I serve. I was smiling because I know the size of God. I know how incredible this God is. I know what this God can do. I was smiling. I told him, I'll be right back. I went home and I reminded God why I cannot have ovarian cysts inside of me. Mashekenda libra handish. I fasted. I took the communion and I had this feeling within me that God had answered my prayers. I went back to the same doctor, Mashakatash. I'm sharing this testimony for you to know that the knowledge of the size of God destroys fear and anxiety. Because as a child of God, you're going to face challenges. That's why you need the knowledge of God. When I went back to the hospital, the doctor was searched and was looking for ovarian cysts, couldn't find it again. This incredible God, the master surgeon, I didn't need to go for any surgery. The master surgeon himself visited me and took ovarian cysts out of me. People of God, I'd like you to give the Lord a big hand. He did it. My animal Shakanda, because I have a good understanding of the size and the awesomeness of this God. Hallelujah. One time I was pregnant with one of our children. Most cases when I'm pregnant, 5 months, the baby's head will be down, and it stays like that till the day of delivery. But this time, I was pregnant so many years ago with one of our children, and the head was down. And when this baby was like 7 months, going to 8 months, close to the delivery, the head came up. Makonda Labash. Why am I sharing my own testimony with you? For you to know that the knowledge of this God destroys fear. And I went to the hospital, and the doctor said to me, "Madam, we are sorry. You see, your baby is very big now, and there's no more rotation. So it's not possible for the head to be down. The head is up, and we're sorry." And he was just saying sorry, sorry. And I looked at him. I said, "Look at me. With God, all things are possible." And he said to me, "We don't use God here." And I said to him, "I don't know what you use, but I use God." Mashaklande bro tahadash. I was not afraid, because I know the size of God. I know how great this God is. And I came back home and I said, "Lord, with you all things are possible." I said, "This baby's head must go down. You all know it's not safe when the baby's head is up." I prayed and I thank God for my life. Anytime I pray, when God answers, I will know that yes, answer has come. I knew that God had answered me. I went back to the same hospital. And when I got there, the doctor checked. He couldn't believe it. He said, "What? The baby's head is down. At this stage, impossible." And I said to him, "You have to glorify my God. That is the God we are serving." If I didn't know the size of God, I didn't know his capacity and ability, I would have been afraid. Awesome God. I'd like you to understand that this knowledge will help you. When you have this understanding of the size of God, it will help you to take giant steps and do exploits. Maximize your destiny, maximize your potentials, and leave your footprint on the sands of time. The knowledge of God. Ephesians chapter 3, verse 20. It said, "Now my God that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above that which I think or imagine." I pray that as your knowledge of God comes alive, it will exceed your expectation in Jesus' name. The knowledge of God will make you to say, even though I'm not from a rich family, even though I don't have any connection, even though I don't know anybody, mashakata, I'm going to make history. Because God has wired me for success. He has wired you for breakthrough. He has wired you for lifting. The knowledge of God will make you to say, even though I'm not born with a silver spoon, even though I am from a poor background, I am not born poor, I have a great God, and therefore I will not die small. The knowledge of God. The knowledge and the size of God will make you to look at yourself and say, "This shaking must come to an end. This shaking in my marriage, this shaking in my job, this shaking in my business must come to an end." The knowledge of God, it will destroy fear. It will make you to say, "This shaking that I'm going through concerning my child, concerning my job, will come to an end." In Job chapter 19, verse 25, Job, when he was going through his own shaking, he said, "I know my Redeemer liveth." That was what he said. Because of the knowledge of the size of God. And the Lord turned his captivity. You know his story. The Bible says in Proverbs chapter 23, verse 18, it says, "Surely there is an end." That's what you will say. You say, "This shaking, there's going to be an end." Now it is time for us to pray. It is time for us to pray. This is a very important segment in this program. Prayer is the most effective weapon of the believer.
Sometimes I get a little bit worried and uncomfortable when I see Christians who don't have passion for prayers. In this wicked world where people are praying that you should sleep and not wake up. In this wicked world where people are angry that you're looking beautiful and you don't love prayers. How do you cope? I cannot cope without praying. I just cannot. Because I know that the days that we're in is evil. Mashaklahande brokata. A world where you've done nothing wrong to people. They just hate you out of sheer jealousy. They go around saying filthy things about you. Things that are not true about you. Haven't you noticed? People you didn't do anything to. People that used to like you. Friendly with you. All of a sudden they will see you, they'll start making face. And you didn't do anything to them. And you're asking yourself, because somebody has gone to tell the person wrong things, filthy things, things that are not true about you. And that's why the person is angry with you. And listen to me. If that's your experience, don't start asking yourself, what have I done? Ignore them. That person was never your friend. If that person was your friend, that person would defend you. That's what I do. If you hear anything about me that is not true, and you are making face for me, I'll face front. I will ignore you. It is scriptural to avoid people. Go and look at Romans chapter 16, verse 17. It is not a sin to avoid people. Avoid them and go your way. I am one of the most peaceful women on earth. I know it. I don't need anybody to tell me. And yet, people still look for my trouble. And I pity them because they will suffer. Because God will first of all ask you, what did this woman do to you? Very peaceful. People who know me this land can tell you. I go my way. I don't even have time. That's why I say to people, find your purpose. If you have find purpose, you won't have time for people. That's the truth. Do I have time for people? So I'm telling you this. You need to be prayerful because people are wicked. They just look at you. They are wondering that you don't have the problem that they have. And I don't understand. Because God has plans for his children. They hate you because you don't have the problem that they have. People are paying price to have testimonies. It's of you to get close to them. And yes, for me, if you ignore me, you are the one that will lose. Because if you come close to me, you're only going to benefit from me. So if you make up your mind, you don't want to be my friend, you are the one losing. So I'm advising you, if that's your condition, you don't need to start begging them. They don't belong in your destiny. People who know you will love you. Somebody said to me, say, there is nothing anybody will see about you that I will believe. Say, because I know you. And anywhere people say bad things about you, I will defend you because I know. So I'm telling you this so that you'll be prayerful. Because God will vindicate you, Mashakata, and give you victory over them. I like us to pray right now. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Whatever that shaking is in your life, whatever it is you are trusting God for your sister, for your brother, concerning your husband and your children, concerning your career and your business, I want you to open your mouth right now. Do you want God to show you mercy? Do you want God to be compassionate unto you? Whatever it is, open your mouth. Are you sick? Are you troubled? Don't be tired to pray. Do you want God to empower you? Prayer is not only for needs. If you want empowerment, open your mouth and pray. Mashakla mande bontalabasha. Pray in your understanding. Pray in the language of the spirit. Father, I stand in the gap. Make a day in the put a name, oh God, to the shaking in the life of my audience, in the life of every member of understanding life. Lord Almighty, whatever that problem is, whatever that challenge is, oh God, I cry for a divine intervention. I ask, O Lord, for a visitation that will culminate into laughter after the order of Sarah. Liganama Zedebo Shata, Elia Mandebro Saladasha, Lagabandebro Segedesha, Iclamandobo Zorosha, Mayanemo Shata, Ilagadabayanama Segedesha, Ilagabayanemo Sogodosha. Father, visit them today. Transform their life, O God. Area mashekete liga bayana mazegedesha yakapasoria mandasha. Whatever it is that makes them to cry, oh God, I pray that you visit them today. Whatever it is that makes them, oh God, unhappy, I pray that you visit them today. In the name of Jesus Christ, lima shakande lebontaha. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We serve a God that answers prayers. I know He has heard our prayers. Thank you so much for joining me again today. I appreciate you. Thank you so much. I just like you to send in your comment, because if you don't send your comment, I won't know you are connected. Send your comments, send your contributions. Really, truly, I appreciate them. Thank you so much for your comment, your contributions, your prayers for me. God bless you so much. And I must not fail to appreciate every member of Understanding Life. Thank you so much for celebrating me big on my birthday. Thank you so much. Thank you. From 12 a.m. to midnight, my phone was on fire. Thank you so much for your love. Thank you for loving me. I was really overwhelmed by love. Thank you so much. And I must not fail to appreciate my husband, my darling husband, and my children. Before I came out of the room, the living room was just decorated. They were singing. In fact, it was fun all the way. I really enjoyed myself. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. And God bless you. All right. Thank you. I want to say a big thank you to all of those that reposted the video, the birthday picture. All of you that reposted it. Thank you so much. I appreciate you. And I want to say thank you to all of you that are sharing this video. Thank you so much. You don't know what you are doing. Listen to me. Anytime you support a divine agenda, you attract heaven's reward. That's the truth. You see, we all have the reason why we are born. So if you see anyone who has found purpose, it is wisdom for you to support that person. Because even if you don't support, what God will do, He will do. So it is wisdom for you to support that person. Because it's not a time to be envious of the person, because the person is fulfilling purpose. So that's why I'm taking time to appreciate all of you for supporting this work. I pray that God will bless you. For everyone sharing this video, supporting this divine agenda, I speak blessing in the name of Jesus. I speak lifting in the name of Jesus. I speak breakthrough in the name of Jesus. I speak increase in the name of Jesus. I speak sources. I pray that that hand sharing the video is blessed in the morning, blessed in the afternoon, blessed in the evening. In the precious name of Jesus, any form of delay in their lives, I decree a name to it in Jesus' name. Thank you so much. I appreciate you. God bless you. And I'd like to say to all of you who want to connect with me live, the best way to connect with me is to like my page. Just search for Understanding Life with Mrs. Favour Vitry. Just like the page. And for those who watch me via YouTube, just, you know, click on the subscribe button and then click on the bell sign and you will get notification when I come on air. And I want you to know that I have a weekly program now on Instagram. Hallelujah. I have a weekly program. There's one area I know God has really graced me, and that's the area of revelation. I don't struggle to have revelation when I study. As I speak to you now, I have lots of topics the Lord has given me for this program. I just pray for grace and time, you know, to share. That's one area I'm graced. So I started a topic on Instagram called Truth. And the Instagram family, they are blessed already. I'd like you to connect. My Instagram address is at Understanding Life with Favor. At Understanding Life with Favor. That's my Instagram address. So you can join me for my weekly program called Truth. Hallelujah. God bless you so much. All right. If you're joining me for the first time, my name is Mrs. Favour Vitry. A woman of God appointed by God for this generation. A kingdom ambassador. The founder of Understanding Life. I have been preaching the word of God for 9 years. I'm married with children. And I live in the city of Vienna, Austria. Most Sundays I'm here doing what I'm born to do. Preaching the word of God, talking about every issue of life, and helping people to write and pass the exams of life in order for them to find true joy and be happy in life. God has been using this platform to be a blessing to so many. And I know today, God is going to reach out to you in a unique way. I'd like you to invite friends and family. Let people know what God is doing in this platform. All right? Also, don't forget to get your notepad and a pen. Just put down something that you want to remember or probably want to share with friends and family. God bless you. All right. Now, I started a topic a couple of weeks ago, captioned, "What God is missing in His heart." And we've been doing this, elaborate this amazing series. Very broad topic. All right? Because we've been looking at the different attributes of God, which is actually missing in the body of Christ. If you've been conversant with recent happenings, you know, you will understand that really, truly, what God is missing in His house. On my birthday, a woman of God called me to facilitate with me. And she said to me, she shared some few things with me, all right, which I would want to share now because I know I'm doing a live video. And she said to me, "Really, truly, what God is missing in His house." All right, so we've been doing this topic. If you know that you've not been following me, just try, go watch. I'm on YouTube. Just try and go to my page and watch my previous videos. And then you'll understand what I'm talking about. And also you'll be blessed. So we're doing this wonderful series. And God has, you know, lives are blessed. All right, so today I want to talk about another unique attribute of God, which is missing in the body of Christ, which is humility and compassion. All right? A unique attribute of God that is rare in the body of Christ and Christian families and in our individual lives. Before I go further, I'd like you to understand that humility is not stupidity. I'd like you to know that meekness is not weakness. All right? Because a lot of people believe that if you play with everybody, you laugh with everybody, including those who are ready to poison you, to kill you, who don't wish you well. And then you are humble. Because you don't know the meaning of the word humility. The word humility means lack of pride. And remember, pride is a thing of the heart. There are people who can bow down, lie down to greet you, yet they are full of themselves. When people see people who are bold and confident, they think that the person is proud because you don't know the meaning of humility. As a Christian, it is not out of place to be bold. For the Bible says in Proverbs chapter 28 verse 1, it said the righteous, they are as bold as lion. Man de brush. It is not out of place for you to make boast in God. It is scriptural. Mekonda raba shata. If you look at Psalm chapter 34 verse 2, it says, "My soul will boast in the Lord." So it is scriptural. So when you see people who are bold and confident, they are not proud. They simply know who they are in the Lord. Librahan de zege librahan de shakatash. So that's it. This is very important. So you have a good understanding of what we are talking about. As a matter of fact, when God sees someone who is bold, he backs the person up. If you see David, ask David. It was the boldness of David that made David to enjoy God's backing. And he brought down Goliath. May the Lord give us understanding in Jesus' name. I like to say to everyone who is a leader in various capacity, listen to me. You are not made a leader to lord it over people. You are made a leader to be a positive influence. You see people, they are made leaders and they oppress people. They torment people. You want people to respect you? They don't respect you that way. Listen to me. You don't demand for respect. You earn it. Your attitude. You are not called to oppress those people. You are called to be a perfect example. You are called to make a difference in their lives. You understand? Because as a matter of fact, you've been elected by God, chosen by God to lead them. You are not better than the people you are leading. That's the truth. On this platform, I say the truth. You are not just a privilege given to you by God. And you don't need to abuse it. Pride. For people, we are normal in church until they made them a leader. They became abnormal. Some of them are actually on their way to hellfire because they made them a leader. Pride entered into them because they don't know the meaning of leadership. Leadership is influence. That's the truth. You see some pastors, because of pride, they've missed the helper of their destiny. And don't tell me because you're a pastor, you don't need a man. Even God himself recognized the need for a man. He said in Ezekiel chapter 22 verse 30, I sought for a man. When God gives you an assignment, he gives you people to support that assignment. Some of them, they've come to your office and just 50 members that you have. You have 20 protocols. And people will have to fill 50 forms to be able to see you. You make yourself so inaccessible. There will 50 members. There will fill forms. You have how many protocols? Pride. And because some of them, you've seen crowd. You have 1,000, 2,000 members. And then pride came upon you. You don't even have value for prayers. You don't even fast unto God. You have no value for fasting. You have no value for prayers anymore because you have just 2,000 members. Can you do this work without the owner of the work? This is a spiritual house. You must build it spiritually. Even if you have 1 million members, humble yourself before the one that called you. The higher you go, the more you pray and fast, because there are people who are watching to pull you down. I like us to understand that we should be careful of people we let into leadership roles. People we allow to play leadership roles, because a lot of them, they don't know the meaning of leadership, so that we don't destroy them and send them to hell. May the Lord give us understanding. I have been privileged to be a leader in various capacity for years, and the people I'm leading can tell you. One time we're having a get together in this land, the people I'm leading, I went to the kitchen myself to cook. I'm not lying. I'm telling you the truth. They didn't take anything from me. They didn't make them to look down on me. If I'd even made them to love me the more. I went to the kitchen myself to cook. We're having a get together. Because I have an understanding that I am to be a servant leader. Jesus Christ, the icon of Christianity, he was a servant leader. The Bible says in John chapter 13 verse 5, he washed the feet of the disciples. He washed the feet of the disciples. John 13 verse 5. Jesus Christ. Our perfect example. What are we talking about? This is very important. So you don't begin to... If the people you are leading, they are not happy with you. Listen to me. Your service will not be accepted. And if your service is not accepted, it will never attract reward from heaven. And remember, the same God that chose Saul rejected Saul. My enemies are he. These are the things. Anytime I remember them, they put me on check. So that at the end of my journey on earth, I will not be a castaway. Ashakatash. I know God is speaking to someone. That's the truth. We should put all of these things on check. This is very important. You see people in church, no matter the praises, they cannot dance. They cannot move their body. The praise leader will praise and praise and praise. She's tired. They can't move their body because of pride. They don't want their makeup to wash off. They feel big before their creator. And they turn church to a parade ground. From the beginning to the closing, you see them walking around the church because they want to show their new dress. And listen to me. They want to show their new dress, walking around, distracting people from having rhema. When the word of God is going forth and you are walking around, there's a catching moment when the word is coming and you are walking around, parading around.
distracting people from having rema. The pastor is preaching because you want to show your new dress. And you same people, you hear them say, I cannot repeat the same outfit. What I wore to church the other time, I will not wear it second time. Why? Because of pride. As if listen to me, your dressing is not what defines you. You are defined by the word of God. And that you put on new clothes to the church does not mean you are rich. There are people who put on new clothes, they borrow money to buy those clothes, and their account is on red. They cannot boast of 1,000 euro in their account. That's what say that it's not that you're putting on new clothes. That's not what makes you. I know people who are rich. They give out aircraft. They still repeat their clothes. They wear it. That's the truth. Because you don't know. Because you want to prove. You want acceptance. You have low self-esteem. You want acceptance. You want to buy love. You want to prove that you are great. Listen to me. It is not your dressing. Greatness does not begin with dressing. It begins with self-discovery. Knowing who you are and why you are here. That's how greatness begins. It doesn't begin with what you put on. So stop telling yourself, do I dress? Am I against dressing? No. I dress very well. I put on what I'm comfortable in. I don't follow the crowd and I don't follow the trend. That's it. If you like, you're on your own. I don't look at people. I put on what I'm comfortable in. And I whatever I wore before, I can repeat it. It's not a big deal. And that does not mean I'm broke. It's not about that. I don't blow my trumpet. That's the truth. So it's not that if you're putting on clothes, you want to belong to a particular clique, you want to belong to a particular class. If people are not accepting, you form your own class. I've told you before, the only way to enjoy life, even God that created human being, he regretted creating human being. So it's not you that you not regret. So the only way you can be free, don't live your life to impress or please people. Live your life to please God. That's the only way you can live it. You can be free. This is very important. Because I hear people say it all the time. I've heard it over and over again. I need a new clothing. For what? For what? You are not only proud. You have a low self-esteem. Because you know who you are. You want to put on clothes for people to accept you and all of that. Because whether you put on, that's not what you mean. I've told you, if you want people to love you and be a positive influence in their life, impact their life, and they will accept, they will like you. You put on all of that's not what will make you acceptable. That's not it. This is very important. So I'm not against dressing, but don't go and borrow money. Wear your size part time. There's time for everything. Don't feel big. Let your motive be right when you dress. It's good to look good, but let your motive be right. Not because you want to show off, you want people to accept you and all of that. People will hate you, they'll still hate you whether you dress good or not. So that's not it. This is very important. And you don't need to be wasteful. You have to be futuristic. All of these clothes, they are not assets. They are liabilities. I'm an accountant by profession, and I can advise you on this, even though we are not talking about financial matters today. You should focus on those things that appreciate in value, not all of those things that are not. All right? We're not talking about financial matters today. That would be another topic for another time. Okay, so this is very important. You see some people today, because they are graduates, they must work in oil company. The job is not forthcoming. They can't do something else. They sit at home and they are begging. Listen to me, there's no dignity in begging. There's only dignity in labor. So that your car, you can use it to start doing transportation, pending when your job will come. I heard of a graduate who was selling on the street, and there, his miracle job met him. That's how to live. You see some people, because they have little money in their accounts and we cannot hear what. Listen to me. And they're so full of themselves. Listen, your poverty, what you think your prosperity is somebody's poverty. Some people, if they have that money you have in your account, they'll say they are broke. So let's humble ourselves, because that is what Jesus Christ represents. Humility. This is very important. And you see a lot of people. Recently, by virtue of what I do on social media, I talk to people a lot. Very recently, a family, I won't mention names because I'm on a live video. A family, there was a fight. And the man said that, I know that I'm wrong. Now, I'm just quoting him. I know that I'm wrong. But I am the man, and so I cannot apologize. I don't understand. How does gender exempt you from saying I'm sorry when you are wrong? That's it. Pride.
He accepted that he was wrong, but he won't say sorry. Gender does not exempt you from saying I'm sorry. And you see some women, this same unique virtue has ruined a lot of families. So women can't stay in their husband's house today because of this. They can't respect their husband because they feel they are beautiful, they feel they are educated, they have money. And everything. Listen to me. Why would you on earth marry a man you cannot respect? I won't do that. A man you cannot respect. Why would you? Why would you marry a man you cannot respect? Actually, know someone. As I speak to you now, the marriage is over. So full of herself. Honestly. And I see some ladies today, I'm like, this one, anybody that marries this one has married problem. Inside them, you will see complaint. You will see jealousy, competition, hatred. Inside one person, anger. And you tell me, any mother has married problem. It's not, you didn't marry a wife. You have married Wahala. And get ready. I'm telling you this for you to know that all of these things will not take you anywhere. All you need is to humble yourself before the Most High God. Humility, compassion should be found in the church, should be found in Christian families, should be found in our individual life. Even when I'm talking to you every day, I pray, Lord, humble me. Humble me. Humble me. I don't want the spirit of pride in my life. Humble me. Humble me. People can have wrong impression about you. But the most important thing is that God that sees your heart knows the truth. There are people who form humility and yet they are not humble. So it's a thing of the heart. My time is up again today and I need to go. Thank you so much for joining me to the end. But before I go today, I have to lead some people. I want people to give their life to Christ. And the anchor scripture for this segment is Mark chapter 8 verse 36. It said, what shall it profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses soul? Couple of weeks ago, I saw a video of a woman who was just dancing. As she was dancing, she fell down and died. She was dancing. She didn't know she was going to die the next minute. So what shall it profit you if you gain the whole world and lose your soul? Right now, I want to lead you to say the salvation prayer. It's very easy. Lord Jesus, I accept you today as my Lord and personal Savior. I know I am a sinner. Come into me and save me. Wash me clean with your precious blood. Write my name in the book of life. Thank you, Father, for saving me. If you say this prayer, you are born again. You are a child of God. Look for a Bible-believing church where they preach the Word of God. Join a service group. Start serving the Lord and start enjoying the Lord. Thank you so much for joining me again today. I appreciate you. Till I come your way again, keep shining in the Lord. And I wish you a glorious week ahead. Bye for now.